Corey Collins.
And I'm Jenny Burton. Welcome to Carolina Connection, a production by the Carolina School of Broadcasting.
We open this show with a story about a local organization that has made headlines in recent weeks. Charlotte's Habitat for Humanity chapter just celebrated a milestone moment in new home construction for the needy. But you may not know that Habitat has branched out to help other people in other ways. Lauren Umstead explains.
In 1984, the first Habitat for Humanity house was built in Charlotte. Since then, Habitat and local volunteers have been busy. This past January, they celebrated the completion of the 1,000th home in Charlotte. When the recession began several years ago, local Habitat officials realized that there was an abundance of existing homes readily available. That sparked an idea called the Neighborhood Revitalization Initiative. This program helps people buy foreclosed homes.
It's less expensive, and it takes a lot less volunteers to accomplish our objectives.
Someone who has benefited from the Neighborhood Revitalization Program is Sonny Townsend.
I didn't come to Charlotte to get a home. I didn't. I came to Charlotte not to die from alcoholism.
While in rehab, he found out about Habitat's foreclosure program.
In the beginning, I never thought that, you know, it was even possible that I could get a home. I didn't think my credit was good enough. And, you know, they said, like, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You know, it's like, trust us, and I did.
So our desire is to try to keep families in their homes, number one. Number two, to try to work with the neighborhood and to get homeowners back in these homes so that the neighborhoods can recover as quickly as possible.
The revitalization program is not a handout, but a hand up. Homeowners still have to pay for the home and are required to help with any renovations, but they don't have to pay closing costs or interest.
I just fell in love with it from the very minute I saw it. And you know, at that time when I came in, it was all concrete floors and bare walls, and it was a mess. And it needed a lot of love and attention and a lot of work, and I was willing to do all that. And you know, it's when I look now at this, it's just amazing. It's like I'm going to wake up and it's not going to be here. I hate it that, you know, somebody lost their home in order for me to receive a home. But I'm gonna take really good care of the house.
But all homes eventually need repairs, and Habitat also has what's called the Critical Home Repair Program.
There are families who already own their own home that have large repair needs. So families have to be willing to repay for the materials and subcontractor costs that we provide, and then they also have to be willing to do community service.
They're doing a reconstruction on my home. It's almost like what's that, Home Extreme Makeover? I want to say move that bus when they finish. And plus the fellowship, I am enjoying everybody that comes here.
Licensed contractors supervise volunteers who did 21 critical home repairs in 2010.
If I didn't have Habitat help to work on my home, that'll be something I have to pay out of my pocket, and I wouldn't be able to do all the work that they are doing. Some of it really would have been necessary, but some of it I probably would just let go. But I thank them for just walking through, seeing what needs to be done, and they are doing more than enough.
We believe in providing affordable housing and preserving affordable housing, but we really want to be about transformation. That is what we desire as an organization. And so in the Critical Repair Program, like all our other programs, we really desire to see community and life and home transformation.
And Sonny Townsend, who has received help from Habitat, wants to become a role model.
You know, they've just improved my life 1,000%. I never thought that I would be a homeowner. I really thought I'd be a renter the rest of my life. And even with the responsibility that comes with home ownership, it's just such a sense of freedom, and it's such a sense of accomplishment. It's just changed my life totally. I want to be a good influence in the community, and I want to be an example to my neighbors.
This is Lauren Umstead reporting for Carolina Connection.
To follow the Carolina School of Broadcasting, check out our website at csbradiotv.edu or on Facebook by searching Carolina School of Broadcasting.